Yes.
Yes.
So what is information?
May I answer?
Yes, sure.
Information is data after processing or computing.
After processing?
Yeah.
What is the difference between data and information?
Data is something like random. We have to manage it and make it in sections and query it. Information is something we can understand it.
May I answer, Doctor?
Yes.
The information is data has been processing and show to the user.
Okay. Any other guy?
Yes, Doctor. For the information is just a collection of facts.
Election
I can say that.
Facts. Yeah.
Yeah, more or less all of you are right. It is, if I say it is an organized data. Information is organized that you can understand something. Whereas the data can be the raw data that you cannot understand.
Okay.
Okay.
Excuse me?
Yes.
Okay. I just understand.
So now, what is system? It says a system is a set of elements or components that interact to accomplish
goals.
So it means if I say the computer system, what does it mean? Set of elements or components. So it means in CPU, if CPU is a system, so there are different elements or components inside. What are the components? What are the components?
Motherboard and
motherboard, hard disk. You have RAM, ROM. There are many things. Okay, and
yeah,
all collect together become a system.
Yeah.
Okay, so system is a set of components that is used to achieve something. Why we use CPU or computer system? To process the information, we will get
yeah,
some output, we will use something for some purpose.
Yeah.
Okay. There are many systems. Automatic car system, there is a washing system, car washing system, there is laundry system, there are so many systems in our life.
Yeah.
Okay, systems have, all of you know, inputs, processing mechanism, and output and feedback. So there are four things involved here.
Yeah.
If you take the example of computer system, what are the input?
The data.
The data that we entered through? You will give the input through?
To
the system.
A car.
I mean, you have
computer system. Accomplish. To the accomplished goals.
You have computer system. How I can give the input?
Through the keyboard or?
Yes, through the keyboard.
Yeah.
I will give the input.
Or
input goes
microphone.
In CPU.
Yeah.
Or like in case of mobile, we have a screen, so I will give the input through a screen.
Yes.
And it will go inside.
Yeah.
The CPU, the system, the elements, the components, they will process the information. They will change it into another form and show the output through monitor or screen.
Or speaker.
Okay, yeah. This is the general criteria. And also the feedback. Like you are giving me the feedback, teacher's screen is freezing. This is your feedback.
Yes.
Got it?
Yeah.
So these four things are usually involved in a system. It's a complete process, actually. What is process? A system processes the input to create the output. What is process?
The input to create the output.
No process in general. What we call
it's CPU.
In Arabic, what we call it in Arabic process?
Mu'alij.
Mu'alij?
Yeah, mu'alij.
Process, mu'alij, of course.
Is process will like a process.
Process.
Process. Process. بروسس لا معالجة وفعل معالجة بروسسينج هي معالج
so if I ask processor. You define process
may I answer doctor
yes
it's transforming the input into some useful output
yes so
I think
what
that's correct
during the transforming It means there are different steps are involved.
Yeah, different steps.
What we call steps in Arabic?
Khatwat.
Khatwat. So if I ask you the majmua khatwat.
Yeah.
It's called mu'alaja.
Yes, mu'alaja.
The process. Now you understand what is the process. There are different steps. Set of steps. Okay? So we have steps here. One step is input, other step is processing mechanism. Then we have output, then we have a feedback. Okay, and this is called the system process. Okay, example of systems are everywhere, an automatic car wash, the heating in a building, the human body. You should be able to think many more. Can you tell me more systems?
Doctor.
Yes.
What's mean feedback here?
Feedback is look, you receive an output. You give the input. After processing, it will give you output. And now after output, is that good or bad? It will serve the purpose or not. So this is feedback.
The purpose is feedback.
Yes, the continuous improvement, you can say. For example, you will submit the assignment. I will give you the feedback. So what is the purpose of feedback?
Okay. I guess it's
getting good results.
Great.
اللي هي التغذية الراجعة. No.
So can you tell me some examples of systems? Like automatic car wash. There are a lot of systems in your house.
Hello, calculate.
Your voice is not clear. You know the GIS system? Can you hear my voice, guys?
Yeah. Yes,
we do. GIS? Yes, Hassan is writing AC, air conditioning system. Yes. GIS, the Google map, you know?
Yes.
What else? Automatic door lock system. Automatic bell, automatic garage in your house. Most of you have, I guess.
Yeah.
Automatic lighting system. These are all systems. You know, we are living in the systems world. If you go to the restaurants, you will see. If you go to the some big hotel, you will see a lot of systems. The door locks, you know. Now we have robotic systems. Even the maids are robots in the world. It's available now soon. You will see automatic car systems. So there are many systems. Is that clear?
Yeah, clear.
Yes.
Now, what is information? As we discussed earlier, it's an organized form of data. Information is a collection of facts that you can understand, that you can perceive. It can take many forms, text, numbers, images, audio clips and video clips are all examples. Closely related term is data. This is another term, data. These two terms are often used interchangeably. It says it used interchangeably here, but usually they are not same. Data sometimes, most of the time, is in unorganized form. Okay?
Okay.
Whereas in information is a collection of facts means that it is in organized form that you can understand. You can perceive something. Yes, Hassan is also saying, can I say smart home is a system? Yes. There are many in smart home, there are many subsystems there. So is that clear, data information?
Yeah, yeah.
These are the basic things. I'm expecting all of you know these things already. Okay, now come to the information system. So we talk about the system. You understand what is system. We also talk about information. And now, if we combine both information system. So it means the information is processed somewhere in the system. Is a set of interrelated components that collect input, manipulate, and store and disseminate like output information and provide feedback mechanism to meet an objective. Did you get this? What is information system? You know what is information, you know what is system. So what is information system?
Like input and processing and output.
Processing what?
Machines.
Machine will process what?
Data.
Data, information.
Yes. Yeah, to get the information.
They will, the system will get the information and process it. That is called information system. The input will be information, then there will be a processing, storage, and output, and the feedback mechanism.
Yeah, yeah.
In information system, input is the activity of gathering and capturing data. What is input?
The data.
In information system?
An information system
that will gather and capture the data, and processing that convert it into in some form. Okay.
Okay.
And output that you are producing result that you can understand and you can see something in the form of reports, and then we have a feedback of from the system that is used to make changes to input or processing activities. So these are the generic steps, all of you know this, but I want to know some examples from you guys. You will understand in a better way if you are able to give me the example of information system.
The sign of student.
Sign of?
Student.
I didn't
or, when I want to know my grade, so I should to enter the
information.
Yeah, enter my data, my
yes.
My ID number, and this
yes.
is processing and give me the my grade.
Okay,
so that's
absolutely fine. But what we call this system?
Information system.
This is information system, but it has some name.
It has
the system that you are using to see your grades. Where you are going to see your grades? Which system?
The student
system information.
Student information system. Okay, that is good. But this system is available?
Yeah.
In PeopleSoft. Right?
Right.
Yeah.
You know the PeopleSoft.
Yeah, we call it like
So PeopleSoft is an information system that actually it is an ERP kind of system. Inside there are many small sub information systems. So student information system, can you give me, you are very right, it's very good. It's a good example. So give me more examples.
Like a website, Upshare.
Very good. Upshare is a good example of information system. So it means now you can think we have so many information systems available.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, right.
For your passport, for your car, we have many systems related with the car. You renew your istamara. Okay, I just renewed my istamara. I just log in through Upshare and apply there and everything is done. So this is beauty of information system. You know, I remember when I came in the kingdom 10 years before almost. So renewing istamara is a very difficult task at that time.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you have to go there and there's a lot of manual work going on there. So you need a whole day or maybe sometimes couple of days to spend there and then you will be able to get this. And now it is very easy. I just applied through my Upshare account and I even gave them the address and within 2 days they posted in my house. I didn't go there. So this is the beauty of the information system.
Good.
So now you understand what is the information system. There are some input, processing, output and feedback.
Yeah.
Okay. So usually you give the feedback when you do the online shopping through any app, they will ask you, please rate this, please fill this survey. Like in your assignment, you are going to conduct the survey.
Yeah,
sure. What is the purpose of that? You will get the feedback. You will get the feedback and you will improve your system. You got my point?
Yeah, we got.
Okay. That is good. So moving next. So this is the figure you can see. Defining the information system, the input, processing, then output, and there is a loop. Again, you see, what is the purpose of loop? What is the purpose of
loop? Loop is data. Is...
Feedback is. It's a for continuous improvement.
Yes, it is.
Mute, sir. Doctor.
Yes.
The screen is freeze. I think it's named this.
It's freezing now?
Yes.
Okay, let me stop here. And share it again. So now you can see.
Yeah, we can.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Try to move the mouse.
You can see the figure now?
Yeah, we can.
Okay. So now that's moving on. So now we have a different characteristics of valuable information. When I say this information is very good, very valuable information. So there must be some characteristics for that. Do you agree with this?
But
useful information has some. Yes, guys.
Can you again
repeat, doctor? Could you repeat?
So when I'm saying the useful information, this is a useful information. This is valuable information. So there must be some characteristics for that, right?
Yes, yes, right.
Now, what are those characteristics? We need to see that. The first one, as you can see on the slide, is accessible. Information must be
accessible.
We don't see. Because the screen
you
also has the same
problem. The screen is frozen, I guess.
It's freezing?
Mm-hmm.
Try the. Try move the.
Let me do it again. No option. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Zoom is playing with us today. Okay?
Yeah, it's okay.
Good.
The very first characteristic is accessible. Information should be easily accessible by authorized users so they can obtain it in the right format and at the right time to meet their needs. Can you give me any example for this accessible? The information is accessible. Are you with me, guys?
Yeah, we are thinking about.
For example, I need an Upshare account, or I need something that requires Upshare account. And I don't know how to create an account. I don't know the steps. So I will find out some information about that. So I will visit that website. So on the website, there must be all information available.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I cannot. Sometimes, you know, some websites, they have all information, but they don't have the relevant information, or they don't have a complete, they don't allow you to give the complete information. So
yeah.
Then what's the problem? That you cannot complete your task. So from customer point of view, it's very important that the information must be accessible. If I need something, if I need something, so I can get through the information system from the office, from there, whatever. But there should be, you know, they should allow the information for the customers. Okay?
Yeah, okay.
First characteristic, second one, accurate. It's very normal. In some cases, inaccurate information is generated because inaccurate data is fed into the transformation process. When they are transforming the data, after taking the input, maybe there is some mistake there in calculations. So the output will be inaccurate. Right?
Right.
So this is a very common problem sometimes, especially in the databases. When you're working to storing the information in the databases, the format is, and the information is coming from a variety of sources, and a large amount of data is coming. So there is a chance that there are some error in that. So as a organization point of view, from organization point of view, your information must be accurate, error-free.
Like what, doctor?
For example, you know, sometimes you're creating an account and I'm not sure they are giving you the some code, image code, or your telephone number must be 5-digit or 6-digit or 8-digit, right?
Yes, right.
But when you enter in the database, they have a different value there. Got my point? They are saying that you have to enter 5 digit only. But if you entered 5 digit with one character, they are accepting. The system is accepting that one.
Okay.
There's an error in that system. So, but here we are talking about information. The information you are providing, it must be error free. There should not be the irrelevant or the wrong information there. Okay. Complete information contains all important facts, but no more facts than are necessary. See the simple characteristic below. Okay, we'll see. Complete information does not mean that everything. It means relevant. That is required, actually. Got the difference here?
Yes, the full context of the information.
Yes. The focus information that is actually required, so that will be considered as complete information rather than you are putting the extra information that is not required. Another characteristic is the economic point of view. This is very important and tricky as well. Information should also be relatively economical to produce. Decision makers must always balance the value of information with the cost of the producing it. Yes. Anybody can give me an example for this?
Doctor, complete like library. Complete information like library.
Library. I didn't get you. What is library?
Library.
The complete information means I'm giving you, you need some information about the course. Right? You need some information about the course and I'm giving you the half of the information. I'm not discussing anything. Like I have discussed the syllabus with you, complete information. Okay, and you need this information. What if I give you only this is the course code, this is the name, and this is the CLO. That's it. Is it enough for you?
No.
You need the grading policy. You need the topics. You need about the information about quizzes, assignments.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is called complete information.
Okay.
You got it?
Yes.
Complete means that is actually required. But if I talk about something else, who is the author of this book and that author is living in USA and doing this and that, that is not required. Okay? You don't need that information. You need only a complete and accurate information to the point. This is called completeness. So next is economical, from economy point of view. I need the example for this. From cost point of view, sometimes getting information costs you a lot. And you are doing a business. You have to save the money. I can give you one example. You know, for example, the government has decided to give the medical insurance to the 2% in each family. Only 2% for 2% in each family.
Okay.
Now, you have 100,000 of families living in one country. How you are going to collect this information? You have to collect the information about 2% from each family.
Yeah.
Okay. But later on you find out that it will cost a small to find out 2%. It will cost maybe $100,000.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So later on you find out if we give the medical insurance to all members, family-wise, you do not need to put that money to find out the 2% in each family. It will cost you the same. You got my point? To find a 2% in each family, it is a big task for the government, right? How they are going to fund it? Because there are hundreds of thousands of families in one country. Right?
Yes. But how we count it, all of them?
Yes, how they will create information system, they will create the teams, they will find out from each house. It will require a lot of money.
Okay.
And yes. Later on you find out that if we give all families, so it's very easy. Right?
Yes, now
yeah,
they
right.
sign name and
at the previous cost in this, it will balance it. You find out that it is the same thing. So why we need to give only two? Let's give all of them. So here the decision will play. So sometimes the information that you need is giving you a lot of cost. Okay? So you don't want to do a business in loss. You got the point?
Yes. But doctor, how they account without lose money? This point.
The point is they wanted to they need information. The 2% from each house, from the whole country. So they will launch a project. They will allocate a budget for that. It will cost to the government.
Yes.
Just to find the information. So now this information, after getting this information, is it beneficial for the government or not? Later on you come to know that it is not beneficial. So you will lose money in that way.
Oh, yes. Okay.
So this is the economic point of view. The information you are trying to get or the information you are trying to publish, is it cost effective or not? From business point of view, you have to think. Okay? Is
okay.
that clear, guys?
Yeah, it's okay.
Now moving next to the flexible, that information must be flexible that you can use in different parts of your organization. In one organization, there are different departments. Like we have a CCSIT college. So one is CIS, one is cybersecurity, one is computer science, one is artificial intelligence. Okay?
Yeah.
And the information must be flexible so that we can use in all departments. That can help all departments. Okay?
Okay.
So this is called flexibility. So flexible information can be used for a variety of purpose. For example, information on how much inventory is on hand for the particular part can be used by sale representative. So it says, this information is used by sales representative in a closing sale and also by a
production
manager to determine whether more inventory is needed and also by a financial executive to determine the total value. So the same information is used by different departments for different purpose. Got it?
Yeah, we got it.
That's good. Relevant, yes, the relevant information is important. We discussed this. We need the relevant information, not the extra information. That will serve the purpose, the related information. I want to I want to use my AppShare account, or I want to renew my Istamara. So I need the information related to Istamara and how I am going to renew it. The exact what is required. This is called relevance. I don't need the extra information. Reliable, this is very important, reliability. What is reliable?
Reliable information can be dependent.
Something you can depend on.
Yes. Like if I say Nasser is reliable person, what does it mean? It can depend. We can
dependable.
Trust what he say, what he's saying, we can trust on?
Yeah.
Yes. So some reliable information is very important, can be dependent on. In many cases, the reliability of the information depends on the reliability of the data collection method. From what are the source of information? This is very important. Nowadays, you know, the fifth generation for the online social media, you can see so many fake news. Am I right?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a big problem nowadays.
Yeah.
So the information is reliable or not? It's a very common
not
idea. Everybody's
not
facing.
Reliable.
Yeah. In many cases, so depending on the source, some information is coming from which source? Is that reliable or not? Some information like, you know, the Baldia hack account here? Twitter
yeah.
account?
Yeah.
So we can say it is a reliable source of information. Anything comes from that account?
Yeah.
So now you understand what is reliability and what is the reliable source?
Yes.
Another instance, reliability depends on the source of information. A rumor from an unknown source that oil prices might go up may soon not be reliable. It's very common in stock exchange. You know the guys, stock exchange?
Yep.
Where the people can buy and sell shares of the company. Anybody doing
business.
That business?
Yes.
You are doing? Okay. So, you know, then you understand very well this, that there are sometimes there are a lot of rumors there about the shares. People are saying the oil prices will go up and they suddenly start selling the shares. But actually, it is not the case. Later on, they come to know that they get the loss. Only few people get the profit. Did you notice this thing?
Mostly, we depend on worldwide information, not specific guided information.
Yes, but there are a lot of rumors there, even at country level sometimes, at international level sometimes. Just to play with these kind of things. Anyhow, so if there is any news, any information, so how we can check the reliability of that one? If you are able to know the source of that information, what is the source? And that source is reliable or not? So information must be
reliable.
Secure information should be secure from access by unauthorized user. Yes, it's very important, and it is also a challenge nowadays, worldwide challenge. Every country is facing about these things, and you guys, I think, have heard about it. Just a minute, guys.
Take your time, doctor.
Okay, fine. You know, the American hackers hack some websites,
yeah.
Chinese websites. Pakistani or Indian hackers, they usually fight with each other, try to hack each other's websites. So it happens all over the world. You know, And it is not easy to secure the information nowadays. There are some loopholes all the time available. So this is a priority for any organization. You know the Aramco, they got attacked a few years back. I don't know if you guys know this. I have heard this thing.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Somebody attacked on their data center. And it's very common nowadays. So cybersecurity, we have department here, and it's a very hot area to work with, and you have a good future in that if you are interested in that area. Okay, the information must be simple. Information should be simple, not overly complex. Sophisticated and detailed information might not be needed. So to the point, simple and straightforward. In fact, too much information can cause information overload. Sometimes too much information will, and same applies in the lecture. If the teacher is just speaking a lot of things, maybe you will not understand anything. Yes, am I right?
Yeah. Yes,
if I
right.
Overloaded with the information. So this is gonna be a problem for you. So to the point, straightforward, so that you can easily understand that.
Yeah.
Okay, so timely, time is very important. Timely information is delivered when it is needed. So knowing the last week weather condition, is it important for you? Are you interested in that? The week, last week weather conditions. No, you are not interested. You are more interested in today's weather condition or next week weather's condition. Got it?
Doctor, are you talking about symbol?
No.
I'm talking about timely.
No,
time.
No. I know, but maybe you space or I don't hear you about symbol.
Yeah, maybe you didn't hear that. The information should be simple and straightforward. So extra information sometimes lead you to the wrong way. Maybe you misinterpret.
Okay.
Maybe
okay.
you did not understand that. Or wrong understand.
Okay, yes.
So timely is when the actual information is required in a particular time must be available. Otherwise, there is no benefit for that. I need information now.
Yeah.
So if it is not available, so it is useless for me. Okay, so time matters here. Verifiable, the information should be verifiable. I receive an information, I want to check it, it is correct, it is not correct. So I should be able to check from different sources. I heard that tomorrow is a holiday, somebody told me. So now I want to confirm that. From where I will ask to my head of department, I will ask to the vice dean, maybe the head of the dean of the college. So there are different sources. So maybe I ask to the admin staff. So I can verify these things. So whatever the information is available can be, should be verifiable. From different sources, you can verify it is correct or not.
Yes, correct.
Okay, guys, we're moving a little bit slow. So let's finish a couple of slides, then we will stop today. Okay. An information system can be manual or paper-based. You know the manual system? Information system, manual.
No, system.
The filing system. If you ask your father, maybe the grandfather, how they usually work in at that time in offices. Maybe they have a big storage room for the files. Am I right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Can you see these? Is it available nowadays? Still existing?
No. I think no.
No.
Anybody? There is no files in the offices?
Maybe, doctor. Maybe.
But not like before. But in some countries, still in Pakistan, India, if you go there, you can see in remote areas, they are still there. The internet connection is not working properly in those areas. Still, they have the manual system. And here, I would say maybe the hybrid system. Most of the, it is not paperless environment. We can say it is less paper environment. Got my point? Paperless or less paper?
Yes. Yes.
Can you repeat, doctor, this point?
Paper, if I say paperless environment, it means what? There's no paper.
Oh, okay, okay.
If I'm saying less paper, so it means there is paper, but less paper.
Oh, okay.
Few paper.
I understand that.
Okay?
Okay.
So paper-based. And but we have the computer-based information system nowadays everywhere. Okay, so there are two types of systems, paper-based and computerized. So computer-based information system is a single set of hardware, software, databases, telecommunication, people, procedures, and are configured to collect, manipulate, store, and process data into information.
Yeah.
These are all chapters in our course, right? We will study all these hardware, software, databases. So, what is computer-based system? Collection, majmua of hardware
and software,
databases, telecommunication, people, procedures mean method, that are configured to collect, manipulate means transform, store, process data into
information.
Like PeopleSoft, you give the example, is an information system. We are using hardware or not?
We use
PeopleSoft. Yes, we have some server there where the information will store. We are using the software. How to create that one? And how to manage that one? Like, we have databases. Can you name some databases?
Data.
Databases. No SQL. SQL, Oracle. Are you familiar with these names? Don't tell me you don't know.
Yes. It's a digital databases.
Yes, no SQL. We have so many databases available nowadays. Telecommunications, the signal processing, sending data from one place to another. So you need some telecommunication stuff, like optical fiber. We have coaxial cable. We have different type of environments available. Wireless communication. Okay. Yes, human resource, the people will use the system, the customer or the people are working in an offices. In case of PeopleSoft, the students and the teachers and the admin staff. Procedures, what are the methods and steps that are used to collect the data, manipulate the data, store the data, and process the data into information. You got it? What is computer-based information system?
Yeah, we got it.
There are many in our university, like employee system, like ticketing system. We have the decision support system. We have, about supports related. So there are a lot of systems available here in our university. I think it is enough. We are running out of the time. So we are a little bit slow here. No problem, this is our first lecture, so we will be able to finish this in the next lecture. Is that clear, guys?
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, doctor.
Any question, any confusion, you can ask me.
Doctor, this lecture, I can learn just this or the book?
Well, the book is always recommended. For enhancing your knowledge, book is essential. As a teacher, I would say, yes, you should read the book. But you know, it is also enough that if you go through the slides. But sometimes, you know, some questions are, you know, the
you find
questions.
The, you find the question in the...
Then maybe you need sometimes extra information to understand that.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, some scenario-based questions you will see in MCQs. So it's not, you can do this through these slides, but maybe sometimes it's easy to understand that thing. But of course, you should build a habit of reading book. There's no question about that. Not only this book, the reference book, and all other extra books, the online resources, you have to read everything. Okay?
Okay.
Well, how many students are there? Let's...
Doctor, all resources in Blackboard.
Yes, it's available in the Blackboard.
Okay. Thank you.
System is again stuck here.